This is Tom Biernacki, and today I'm going over L-Arginine, L-Citrulline. I put out a short about both of these, and there was a ton of traffic in the comments, people complaining about one or the other, saying I got it wrong. I'm doing a deep dive today, all the recent studies, how to use it, what I use personally, the pros and cons of each one, how should you use them? We're starting now. L-arginine and L-citrulline are both amino acids that play important roles in the body, particularly in the production of nitric oxide, which is critical for healthy blood flow and heart health. Especially for my patients who have peripheral arterial disease, this may be an option, or is it? They are commonly used in supplements, often for similar purposes, but they have different mechanisms and characteristics. Here's a comparison of their pros, their cons, their benefits, their side effects, and their recommendations. L-arginine. The pros of L-arginine is its nitric oxide production. It's directly involved in the synthesis or the creation of nitric oxide, which improves blood flow and can benefit cardiovascular health. It can help with exercise performance, and it may increase performance, stamina. So if I'm biking, I can bike a little bit longer. It can help with wound healing and immune function. It's been studied and can bolster the immune system potentially. Here are the cons or the side effects. It gives you some GI distress, some stomach pain. It can flare up herpes outbreaks in some studies, inconsistent absorption. There are studies questioning how effective it is. And in fact, there is one study that says it's completely worthless due to its variable absorption. Generally, people take 2 to 6 grams per day. It's best to start with a lower dose and assess your tolerance. Take it throughout the day and see how it's doing for you. But now we're getting to L-citrulline. The pros and benefits of L-citrulline are its conversion to L-arginine. L-citrulline is converted to L-arginine in the body, which produces nitric oxide. So why not just go with L-arginine? Well, studies show that taking L-arginine, it's not absorbed as well as L-citrulline. You want L-citrulline to be absorbed and then converted to L-arginine. Some studies show that taking L-citrulline is probably the better option. It also helps with enhanced blood flow, exercise performance, and recovery, just like L-arginine, because hey, it turns into L-arginine and has some more benefit. The difference is L-citrulline is absorbed, then gets converted, so it's more predictable and you get better absorption throughout your body. The cons and the side effects are, well, it's actually tolerated a little bit better. There's fewer GI issues, less gassiness, but there is a delayed effect. Because you take it, it doesn't kick in as quickly. It needs to be converted from L-citrulline to L-arginine, so the effects are not immediate. And the research is promising, but like L-arginine, there needs to be better comprehensive studies. It's not proven that it does a whole lot of anything, but the studies that do show that it works, 3 to 6 grams per day is what's recommended. It can be taken all at once or divided into doses. The comparison of L-citrulline and L-arginine is that L-citrulline is probably more effective according to most studies. It has better absorption and it gets converted to L-arginine. It just takes a little bit longer to convert. When I look at a lot of the pre-supplements and things being sold, it's probably a little bit more L-citrulline. It has fewer side effects, less gassiness, less GI issues. Both can be effective. L-arginine kicks in a little bit quicker, but has more GI issues, worse absorption. L-citrulline takes a little bit longer to kick in, and we're only talking like half an hour. It has less gassiness, a little bit more effective. So here's what I do practically. L-citrulline, studies do show that it does help, especially with aerobic activity. It can potentially help in wound care. It can potentially help in peripheral arterial disease. This is not a permanent effect. It does increase the blood flow a little bit, but these are more lab studies. They're more mouse studies. What I do is get a pre-workout. For most people watching this, you're working out, you're exercising, you want to get a pre-workout. So I use NutriCost. I find they have pretty good prices. Hey, I'm not getting paid to say this, I promise. Some people do send me free stuff, and this is how I got this. But I have been using a pre-workout for a little while, and it actually makes a pretty big difference. When I take these, I can feel a little bit of tingling. I have a ton of energy. I can feel my heart like amping up. When you're tired in the morning, I like to hit the rowing machine. This definitely helps me out. You know why? It has some caffeine in it. The caffeine obviously gives you a little bit of energy. It has L-citrulline in it. So the L-citrulline is in the dosage that's prescribed. It gives you that extra kick. I can actually feel some of that tingling with the blood flow. Now there's another supplement called beta-alanine, which is also in here. This is known to also enhance endurance and reduce muscle fatigue. Beta-alanine is in here as well. Creatine's not in here, but creatine for athletes is another huge beneficial supplement. And if you haven't heard about creatine, check that out below. It's probably the most studied and the most effective supplement. The studies are extremely safe, extremely beneficial. Check out my detailed guide on creatine use. Creatine is probably my number one go-to athletic supplement. It's made the biggest differences for me, and I think a lot of people would agree. But the reality is, instead of getting L-citrulline by itself, if you're going to be active, maybe just get a pre-workout. I link some of my favorites. I think NutriCost is a pretty good quality, validated one. The prices are probably the cheapest on Amazon. It's a pretty good option. I go with NutriCost for a lot of my supplements, and I link my favorites down below. It does taste pretty good. You just put it in water, you chug it, you get all this stuff that I'm talking about. Now just be aware, when you take this, there is some tingling because it's opening up your blood vessels. The beta-alanine does this, the L-citrulline does this, the caffeine does this. Start with a tiny little scoop. Don't take the full scoop at the beginning. See how your body tolerates it. Let me know if this stuff's working for you. Tell me if I'm shilling out to the big NutriCost manufacturers. I love hearing your opinions. And check out my creatine video if you haven't already.